In this video, I will teach you how to buy and fry parrotfish easily.
Okay, so this is my finished product, fry fish. Yeah, so this is what it looks like. Fry fish ready to heat. So these are parrotfish. Yeah, so
fry parrot. So people who carry parrot go overseas. Yeah, that's what I mean. We're going to show you how you deal with the parrot. So this is put up on Olaba fishing village. So the brother scale up the fish them, you know. A nice one. So then we're going back. I'm going to show you how we deal with the atile and the garlic and thing and various spice and the thing. It's fishing and it's just fishing a pattern. So. Yeah, so we're there. Olaba bay. Yeah, see it? People, see fishermen, vendors, and everybody. Yeah, so you have to get the fish scale up properly, you know, by, you know, when I eat fish, I eat scale. So, the man scale fish, they're living. Yeah, you know, we don't buy little small, ticky ticky fish, you buy reasonable size fish when they fry, you know, you get flesh. They have big bones, so the bone big, less arms here, they're fine. So this is about buying the fish. Further on, tuning back with the seasoning of the fish and the frying of the fish. Alright, so fish scale and ready. Ready to season and fry, so we're still up on the Olaba Bay fishing village. It's a parrotfish them there, no? We're drying the fish now. After you come from the fish market or the seaside, you dry your fish. Yeah, you gotta fry them so you don't want no water and then you dry them. Yeah, so you dry your fish. Kinda see what's like a hand towel. A paper towel, whatever you call it. Yeah, just get the excess water. You gotta fry it in vegetable oil. So when the oil is hot and the water, it have a reaction. I don't know if it's what kind of reaction they call it, but it have a reaction. Splash and things, so you don't want any water. So you just fry it properly. Yeah, this is just fry fish. And fry fish is very simple. So you know some people when they travel from Jamaica going overseas, they fry up their fish and thing. Yeah, this are the process, you know. This is the process. And parrotfish, this process is just for about any fish. But we're using parrotfish today, so if you're using snapper, you know the same thing, you know. To get them scaled properly, dry them, and I gotta show you my season formula, because everybody cook different, you know. So I'm gonna show you what I use. And with these fish are parrotfish, and parrotfish is a very unique fish. They come in different colors. So if you notice, this is some, or when in the background you can hear your dogs barking, this is outdoor cooking, you know. This is in the hills. Yeah, this is from St. Catherine, Jamaica. This is not Kingston, Jamaica. So you hear chicken crowing. Okay, so this is a mixing of the powder scene. So we have a teaspoon, so we gotta use 4 teaspoons of fish seasoning. 1 teaspoon, 2 teaspoon, 3 teaspoon, alright, 4 teaspoon, that's the fish seasoning. And then we're gonna use the black pepper now. Yeah, so these are bulk seasoning, but we just use 1 teaspoon of black pepper. And then we gotta use salt now, table salt. So alright, with the salt now, the salt depends on how you guys use salt. You know, some people don't use much salt. So we put like a half teaspoon of salt.
No, put the 1 teaspoon. It's a lot of fish. Put half more. All right. Yeah, so that's simple. So we use 4 teaspoon fish seasoning, and we use 1 teaspoon black pepper, and we use 1 teaspoon of salt. Yeah, so you mix that here, so that's a dry rub, that's all they use and for the fish. So we gotta use a dry rub and season the fish. They put the fish down. As I say, cooking is a hard, everyone cook different. So we're frying fish. So we gotta slice the fish, put a couple slices in the fish. See me? So this is for 2 reasons. It penetrates the season better, or but when it fry, it's easier to pick the flesh from the fish. So it's for 2 reasons. So you apply just a little pinch inside and outside, pinch again. So you just put a little cut, not in a deep cut, you know. It penetrates the season better, and then when it fry, it kind of have a way you can get to pick it from there, like get the flesh from the fish. So you pinch and put some dry rub inside. You rub some dry rub on the outside, just rub it in. Next side. So now our oil is super hot, but then this is a little thing I need to explain. Now this is thyme, garlic, and 2 scotch bonnet pepper. What you gotta do, we gotta put these in the oil to flavor the oil. I know some people don't put like that, but this is where real flavor come in. So we gotta take the garlic, put the pepper in the bowl like that, put the thyme as it is. In the hot oil, you will see what happened. This is how it go. So, this flavor in the oil. The garlic, you should be here to smell this. It smells so good. It smells good, and there's no fish in the oil as well. So this is some old school method. And this was teaching me by an old lady. Sister, this is how you get the fish, super nice. So sometimes you buy fish from some people and you wonder, oh, this one is nice, and this is what they do. They flavor the oil. So you burn the pepper and the garlic in the oil, and then you extract it from it. Smelling good. There is no fish in it, that's it. Thank you. It's like you fry the garlic. You fry the pepper. Then you extract them from the oil. Take them away from the oil. We serve them sometime I talk. Kind of stupid, I don't know why. If I get too excited or what. It's cooking. So, the oil is super flavorful.
Thank you.
6 fried fish. This is complete, ready to eat.
This is what it looked like. You can enjoy it with family and friends. You can have for dinner, you can have for breakfast, you can have for lunch. It's that versatile. Is it beautiful? Yes, it do. Looking good.
If you like this video, press the link above in this video or below to see more video like this.